Stakeholders in the education sector have been asked to generate ideas and strategies to guide the government on how to incorporate technology use to support learners with special educational needs. Minister Jesse Muyingo, who represented and read out the First Lady's speech, noted that schools have endeavored to enroll learners, but maintaining them has turned out to be a challenge because of the methodologies and materials used.
Such platforms should be used to generate ideas, and as a ministry we expect a lot of ideas and strategies to guide the government on how to support children with a disability in schools. It's my prayer that we all heed to the call for action, that this dialogue will advocate for all the actions that will be advocated for. Let us be accountable for the decisions and implementation of timely actions that will transform the lives of our learners.
Sarah Bugosi Kivoli, the Commissioner of Special Needs Education, who represented the Permanent Secretary of the Ministry of Education, Katie Lamaro, pointed out inadequate funding among the challenges encountered in special needs and inclusive education. Stakeholders also explained the importance of inclusive education.
We also have a challenge of inadequate teachers, those that are trained in special needs, inadequate specialized materials, lack of incentives for teachers teaching children with special needs, and lastly, COVID-19 effects worsened the delivery of education to learners with special needs.
But it's important for all teachers to be aware of some basic principles, right? It starts with being able to identify, do we have children with disabilities in the classroom? There are different ways of doing that, but teachers can do a lot. There's often a lack of data actually at the school level on which child may have a disability. You asked me about the type of help. It should be part of pre-service training. It should be part from in-service training and continuous professional development. You have to equip. You also have to make sure that the attitude is right. It used to be, I hope it is not anymore, that sometimes there was a lot of stigma associated with disabilities, and teachers are the first in line to make sure that the children are accepted.
There are 172,864 students with special needs in primary schools, which is 2% of the total primary level enrollment and 9% of the overall children with special needs. Children with disability need special education since they usually have learning disabilities, intellectual disabilities, physical disabilities, or emotional disabilities. They usually require sign language interpreters, braille transcribers, and specialized teaching methods. Story by Sharon Navasirie for the news.